Buenos días, mi nombre es Pulpo Reporter. No, te estoy haciendo una broma. Soy James, pero estoy disfrazado. No, no, no me he convertido en pulpo. Te habías asustado, ¿eh? Muy buenos días, hoy es jueves 9 de abril, mi nombre es James Reporter y estás viendo La Miranda School TV. En la agenda de hoy nos vuelve a visitar Mary Poppins y de una manera muy especial. Y con mucho ritmo. A continuación será Yen Cheng quien nos cuente un cuento de los números en chino, para luego dar paso al idioma de francés, un cuento en inglés de Miss Liz, un poquito de ya lo sabes, un poquito de mindfulness con Montse Miró. Luego, esta semana estamos repasando cómo se vive la Semana Santa en diferentes países. Pues hoy le toca el turno a Rumanía. ¡Wow! ¿Cómo vivirán allí la Semana Santa? Pues hoy lo vas a descubrir. Luego será la pequeña oruga glotona, The Very Hungry Caterpillar, la que se encargará de contarnos un cuentecito. Un poquito de Butterfly and Flowers, de la mano de Sara, una manualidad muy chula, que espero que seas capaz de hacerla. Y por último, ¿quién cierra el programa cada día? Pues lo cierra el baile del señor Ignasi. Dentro vídeo.
In every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun, and snap! The job's a game!
Yes, that's exactly what I was thinking. I wonder how the children of Lamblander School are doing. Oh, hello everyone! How are you? I was just thinking about you. How are you all doing? Very good, I hope. I was just thinking how much I enjoyed reading that story to you last week. Would you like me to read another one? Yes? Great. Let me have a look in my bag. Very, ooh! Don't you just love it when butterflies fly out of your bag? Let me see. Something in here somewhere, I'm sure. Oh, I don't need that. Oh, don't need that either. Lots of things. Ah, there we go. Here we go. I knew we had a book in here somewhere. Ruby flew too. Let me just get comfortable. I'm just going to put my bag down here on the cloud. There we go. Oh, I hope it doesn't fall down. Right, let me see. Ruby flew too. Once upon a time, upon a nest, beside a lake, there lived two ducks, a mother duck and a father duck. There were five eggs in the nest. Mother duck sat upon the nest all day and all night. Through howling wind and driving rain, looking after the eggs, all five of them. Then one bright morning, the eggs began to hatch. One, two, three, four little beaks poked out into the sunlight. One, two, three, four, little ducklings shook their feathers in the breeze. We'll call them Rufus, Rory, Rosie and Rebecca, said Father Duck. And Mother Duck agreed. But the fifth egg did nothing. Will it ever hatch? Said Father Duck. It will, said Mother Duck, in its own time. And sure enough, it did. She's very small, said Father Duck. What shall we call her? We'll call her Ruby, said Mother Duck, because she's small and precious. Rufus, Rory, Rosie and Rebecca ate whatever they were given. They ate anything and everything, but Ruby ate nothing. Will she ever eat? Said Father Duck. She will, said Mother Duck, in her own time. And sure enough, she did. Rufus, Rory, Rosie and Rebecca swam off whenever they were able. They swam anywhere and everywhere. But Ruby swam nowhere. "Will she ever swim?" said Father Duck. "She will," said Mother Duck, "in her own time." And sure enough, she did. Rufus, Rory, Rosie and Rebecca grew bigger, and Ruby grew bigger too. Her feathers grew out and her wings grew broad and beautiful. And when Rufus, Rory, Rosie and Rebecca began to fly, Ruby flew too. Rufus, Rory, Rosie and Rebecca flew far and wide. They flew out across the water. They flew up among the trees. But Ruby flew farther and wider. She flew out beyond the water. She flew up above the trees. She flew anywhere and everywhere. She stretched out her beautiful wings and soared high among the clouds. Mother Duck and Father Duck watched Ruby flying off into the distance. "Will she ever come back?" said Mother Duck. "She will," said Father Duck, "in her own time." And sure enough, she did. Did you enjoy that? Daddy Duck was a little bit worried about Ruby, wasn't he? Because she was taking a lot longer to do things than all the other duckies. But sometimes that happens. Sometimes it takes us a lot longer to do stuff that other people do a lot quicker. It doesn't mean that we're not going to do them or that we're not going to do them very well. We see a bird flying through the sky. Why not have a look and see if it's Ruby? Bye and see you all soon.
Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. The honey bees that fetch the nectar from the flowers to the comb never tire of ever buzzing to and fro, because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip.
数字一二三四五。六七八九十。
La pyramide alimentaire. De l'eau, on peut en consommer à volonté. Des céréales et dérivés, il faut en manger à chaque repas. Des légumes et des fruits, au moins 5 par jour. Du lait et des produits laitiers, il faut en manger à chaque repas. Viande, poisson ou œuf, une fois par jour. Il faut limiter la consommation des matières grasses. Il faut aussi limiter la consommation du sucre et des produits sucrés. Mangez bien. L'équilibre alimentaire est dans votre santé. Vous êtes capable de dessiner votre propre pyramide? Allez-y!
Hi everybody, it's story time. Are you ready? Let's cross our legs. Let's get our listening ears open. Are you sitting comfortably? Then I'll begin. Today's story is The Bear and the Piano.
The Bear and the Piano. One day in the forest, a young bear cub found something he'd never seen before. What could this strange thing be? He thought. Shyly, he touched it with his stubby paws. Blonk! The strange thing made an awful sound. So the bear left. But the next day he came back, and the day after that too. And for days and weeks and months and years, until eventually, the sounds that came from the strange thing were beautiful, and the bear had grown up big and strong and grizzly. When the bear played, he felt so happy. The sound took him away from the forest, and he dreamed of strange and wonderful lands. It wasn't long before the other bears in the forest were drawn to the clearing. Every night, a crowd gathered to listen to the magical melodies coming from the bear and the strange thing. Then, one night, a girl and her father came across the clearing. They told the bear that the strange thing was called a piano, and the sounds it made were music. Come to the city with us, they said. There's lots of music there. You can play grand pianos in front of hundreds of people and hear sounds so beautiful they will make your fur stand on end. The bear knew that if he left the forest, the other bears would miss him very much. But he longed to explore the world beyond the woods, to hear more wonderful music and play better than ever before. And before long, the bear's name was up in big, bright lights in the big, bright city. He was everywhere. He played sold-out concerts in giant theatres. Every night, he performed with such passion and such grace to wild applause and standing ovations and huge admiration from all the crowds. The bear recorded albums that went platinum. He was interviewed for magazines, he won awards, he met new people every day, and created headlines everywhere he went. The city was everything he'd hoped it would be, but deep down, something tugged at the bear's heart. He had fame and awards and all the music in the world, but he missed the forest. He missed his old friends. He missed his home. So the bear decided to go back. He speedily crossed the river and excitedly bounded into the forest. He couldn't wait to tell his friends about his time in the city. But when the bear reached the familiar clearing, it was empty. No piano, no bears, no anything. The bear started to worry that his friends had forgotten him, or that they were angry that he'd left them behind. Then a friend stepped into the clearing. Hello, cried the bear. I'm back. I've missed you so much. Without saying a word, the grey bear ran back into the forest. Wait, called the bear. I'm sorry I left. Please stop. but his friend just kept on running. The bear stumbled after him, moving deeper and deeper into the forest until he saw something that made his fur stand on end. For the bear had not been forgotten. His friends weren't angry, they were proud. The bear realized that no matter where he went or what he did, they would always be there, watching from afar. They'd even kept the piano safe in the shade, ready for him to return. So, after the bear had told his friends about his life in the city and the many concerts that he'd played, he sat down to play once more, this time for the most important audience of all. The end. Did you like the story? I hope so. Now it's time to draw your favorite part. Have fun!
En nuestra escuela, la Miranda, la educación emocional es uno de nuestros pilares básicos de nuestra formación. En esta área trabajamos técnicas de mindfulness y yoga. Hoy vais a ver una pequeña muestra que nos ofrecen nuestros estudiantes de tercero de primaria, practicando el saludo al sol. Espero que os guste y os animéis a practicarla.
This is the story about Easter in Romania. The oldest tool to decorate eggs is the candle. Geese feathers are also used. Girls and women are sprinkled by boys and men on the second day of Easter. It is believed that perfume makes women and girls stay beautiful all year long. The Easter fair have become very popular in Romania, and they are usually organized in large cities such as Bucharest, Sibiu or Brasov. traditional food in Romania for Easter include eggs and sweet bread. The sweet bread is usually made with nuts or poppy seeds. The Easter bread is made with cheese and raisins and is usually baked only during Easter time. Like in many countries, Romanian children go egg hunt. They think that the Easter bunny has hidden the eggs and has a surprise for them. A lot of people, including children, perform Easter dances. They wear traditional Romanian costumes. The light is an essential element of the Easter holiday. Most families keep the lightning candle after the Mass. They believe it will help them in case of trouble. The night trees are usually decorated with colorful eggs, and they shine at night time. Most families tap the eggs before eating them.
¡Hola, hola! Como sé que os encanta escuchar historias, hoy os he traído una que sé que os gusta muchísimo. Se titula La pequeña oruga glotona, de Eric Carle. Vamos a ver qué nos cuenta esta historia. Una noche, a la luz de la luna, reposaba un huevecito sobre una hoja. Un domingo por la mañana, nada más salir el sol, salió una oruga diminuta, 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 que tenía mucha hambre. Enseguida comenzó a buscar algo que comer. El lunes atravesó masticando una manzana. Pero ¿sabéis qué? Que aún tenía hambre. El martes atravesó masticando dos peras. Pero ¿sabéis qué? Que aún tenía mucha hambre. El miércoles atravesó masticando tres ciruelas. Una, dos y tres. Pero ¿sabéis qué? Que aún tenía mucha hambre. El jueves atravesó masticando cuatro fresas. Una, dos, tres y cuatro. Pero ¿sabéis qué? Que aún tenía mucha hambre. El viernes atravesó masticando cinco naranjas. Una, dos, tres, cuatro y cinco. ¡Cinco naranjas! ¿Pero sabéis qué? Que aún tenía mucha hambre. El sábado atravesó masticando un trozo de pastel de chocolate, un helado, un pepino, una loncha de queso, un salchichón, una piruleta, una porción de pizza, una tarta de frutas, una salchicha, una magdalena y un trozo de sandía. ¡Uf! Aquella noche tuvo un tremendo dolor de barriga. Había comido muchísimo. Al día siguiente, que ya era domingo otra vez, la oruga atravesó masticando una hoja verde, solo una hoja verde. Y se sintió mucho mejor. Ya no tenía hambre. Ya no tenía más hambre. Ni era una oruga pequeñita ya, ¿eh? Se había convertido en una oruga grande y gorda. Se construyó una casa a su alrededor, un capullo, y se quedó encerrada durante más de 2 semanas. Un día hizo un agujerito en el capullo y luego empujó y empujó y empujó hacia afuera. ¿Y sabéis qué salió de ese capullo? ¡Una hermosa mariposa! La oruga se había convertido en una hermosa y linda mariposa. Y con el luz colorado, este cuento se ha acabado. Que os haya gustado muchísimo, como a mí.
you. I hope you enjoy them. Let's go for it!
Let's start cutting the paper roll. We can squash it with our fingers, so it's going to be easier to cut. We are going to cut it into 6 pieces. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Well done. Now, first of all, we need the body of the butterfly. Now, the wings. Now, the wings on the other side of the body. And finally, we need the antennas. So, let's cut this piece. Again, the top and the bottom. We can make the shape of the antenna. One here and the other one here. And here you have the butterfly. Now we are going to make a flower. We need a top and the pieces that we cut before, or you can cut more pieces of paper roll. Let's put these pieces around the top. They are the petals of the flowers. You can put as many as you want. And here you have the flower.
Again, I hope you are having a wonderful Easter, a wonderful week at home with your mommies and daddies, with your brothers and sisters. And today, as always, we are going to dance. The other day, we danced on stage. You remember dancing, doing the choreography, and it was amazing, wasn't it? Today, I had another idea. If the other day, I shut my eyes, and I imagine, and I picture in my head a stage, maybe today I would love to go to a park. Okay, we're gonna go to the park with the slides, and we are gonna do an amazing dance there, okay? But I have to do the little trick. The little trick wasn't like this. I'm gonna close my eyes, I'm gonna imagine the park with all the details, and let's see if it works again, okay? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow, look at me! I'm in a park! Now I'm more than ready to dance. Okay, are you ready to dance from home? Let's do it! Let's start jumping! Well done! Feet together! Super duper! Look, now let's move your shoulder like this! Can you do that? Wow! Remember always your smile on your face, eh? Not like this. Much better. One. Side. Now turn around. Jumping. Another time. Well done, look. Now just clapping with your hands. Side, 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 and forward. Three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Look. Fantastic. Can you try something new? Look. Wow. Try it. Let's jump again. Side to side. Come on, let's cheer up. Move your arms. Look. One, two, three, clap. One, two, three, clap. Look, down, 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 down. Fantastic. Let's imagine we are birds and we are gonna move our wings. We're gonna try to fly. We're gonna try to go to somewhere else. Well done! Super duper! Big kicks to everyone and a big hug. See you soon!
Y hasta aquí el capítulo de hoy. Se despide James Reporter desde la Miranda School TV. Que tengan un buen día.